In 1982, Byron Price published this book. This contains 12 images and 12 verses. If you match the 12 images with the 12 verses, then it reveals the location of a buried treasure. When you find the location of the treasure, you dig it up and there's a cask. Inside the cask is a key. When you take that key, you send it to Byron Price's family and they'll send you a precious gem. This might sound like a wild goose chase, except three have already been found. This is The Secret, a treasure hunt. In 1983, just 1 year after publication of The Secret, the first cask was found in Grant Park, Chicago. In order to find out where the other casks are hidden, we need to look at the ones that have already been found and figure out how they found it, the process that they went through in order to find the cask. That's what this video is about. It's about unlocking how the kids in Chicago found the first cask. The image corresponding to the Chicago cask is image 5, and the verse is verse 12. So let's take a look at it now. The image shows one of the fair people with a castle on his head and a lot of symbolic imagery. You can also see an emerald hanging below his ear. This represents the Irish immigrants of Chicago. Each one of these images is based on a different immigrant group. We may do a full video about each one of these immigrant groups and their representation in the book, but for now we're just going to go through the images and the verses. The first clue that the kids found in Chicago was the windmill. In the image, the windmill, the tower for the windmill, looks exactly like the Chicago Water Tower landmark, which you can see here. Just take off the blades of the windmill and it's almost a perfect representation. Next, they notice the horseman, which they recognize as the horseman on Congress Drive right outside of Grant Park. So they know at this point that the area they're looking at that's represented in this image is Chicago, but they need the verse. So looking at verse 12, we have this, where M and B are set in stone and to Congress R is known. So you have Congress Drive right there. But M and B, they actually couldn't figure out. They looked at the horseman and decided that that meant man and beast. But also right down the street from this is the Chicago Orchestra Hall that has Mozart and Beethoven set in stone on the front of it. So the M and B set in stone is either representative of man and beast or of the orchestra house. So at this point, we already know that M and B, man and beast, is the horseman right at Congress Avenue and at the entrance to Grant Park. But it says, where M and B are set in stone and to Congress R is known. Right next to Grant Park is also the railroad. So they read into that as being R is the railroad that you have to cross to go into Grant Park. Once they crossed into Grant Park, they looked at it again. The next verse is L sits, where L sits. And we're seeing here an image of L, Lincoln, sits in Grant Park. Continuing with the verse, and left, beyond his shoulder is the fair folk's treasure holder. So, this sounds like beyond his left shoulder is the treasure. So, what's beyond his left shoulder? They look and it's a bunch of trees. So, back to the verse, it says, the end of 10 by 13 is your clue behind. So back to the image of Lincoln, behind Lincoln sits a row and columns of 10 by 13 trees. So they go to the end of that, and at the end of that is a fence. The next verse again reads, fence and fixture central to, seek the sounds of rumble, brush, and music hush. So here we're looking at the fence. And the fence shown here is next to the railroad, across from the Chicago Art Institute, brush, and music, a park band shelter, sits nearby. So also the fence and fixture is shown here in the image. So looking at how the Chicago cask was found, the image shows general elements that they found in Chicago. They looked at it, they noticed, hey, this is a landmark in Chicago, we're in the right place, but where do we go? And the horsemen started out at Congress Avenue, right across from Grant Park, and that's what they, when they started reading the verse from there, that led them into Grant Park where they saw Lincoln. There was no image of Lincoln there, and then that said over his left shoulder, and then the 10 by 13 represented the trees, and then they found the fence, and then at the very end, the fence was shown also in the image. So there's a lot of other symbolic imagery in here that are symbols in Chicago that they missed. But generally, if you're just looking at the images, you're probably not going to get that far. You might get to the city, but you're not necessarily going to be able to follow anything. So you're really going to have to be there. There have also been ones that you can look at and get a good general location, like this gives the Grant Park area. So if you can figure out all of the different the symbols in the images, then you can probably get pretty close, but you're definitely going to need the verse in order to get to where you want it. So let's look at a few of those other images that show parts of Chicago. So here, first of all, this shows the Illinois outline, and then over here is a upside down Chicago bull, the spirit of the lake statue, and also the emerald is hanging from the ear, and the ear has this loop, Chicago loop, and the emerald right over Grant Park tells you that emerald, or at least the cask to get that emerald, is in Grant Park. So I hope you enjoyed this video. This is how they found the cask in Chicago, and you can use these details and how they did this process that they went through, to hopefully, you know, go out on your own, find some other ones. If you do, let me know about it. Let me know in the comments if you have different solves for other ones. We're going to be going through a lot here, so let me know in the comments. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and thanks for watching.